as an undergraduate, I knew nothing about the social sciences. My intent was to go to medical school. I did 5 years of training in pharmacy, and my interest was in looking at the impact of medicinal chemical compounds on human biology, basically math and science. And I ended up taking a couple of courses after I was practicing pharmacy, and they were in the social sciences. And I took psychology 101, then I took a research methods course, and they invited me into psychology. And that was the best thing that's ever happened in my life.
I became aware of the importance of developmental science as an undergraduate in college. And I was taking a course on psychology and really became excited by the idea of trying to understand how the mind works and how people's behaviors could be explained, especially with regards to issues of morality and what we call prosociality. So this idea of being kind and generous and nice to each other.
I started research in psychology when I was in my second year of undergraduate. So I fell in love with the notion of trying to figure out why things work the way they do and what matters in a human life, you know, to make us who we are. This was at the time where we were very few so-called minorities in the field.
I grew up in a household where my father was a physician. So I knew for sure I wanted to be a pediatrician until I got to college and faced physics and organic chemistry and things like that. So then I wasn't sure what I wanted to do, and I ran across a program at University of Michigan in community psychology that focused on social justice issues and social change. So that just really intrigued me, and I was introduced there to a lot of developmental scientists and a lot of work in developmental science.
I came to realize that going into developmental sciences was for me in my junior year in undergraduate school at Howard University. I really wanted to try and improve perceptions of Black children. Jensen and some others had said Black children were inferior, they couldn't learn, and I thought that my lived experience in New Orleans public schools didn't give me that notion at all. And I learned that you could do this through research. So I switched from pediatrics and started thinking about psychology and child development as a field.
Initially, I was interested in clinical work, so in clinical psychology. And I just happened to, for one of my first classes in a master's program, I actually had no background in psychology. My background is in music and English and the humanities. My first semester, I ran across a study that was a 10-year follow-up of a program for adolescent mothers and their infants and toddlers, and it had some pretty amazing 10-year effects on both the moms and the kids, and that got me interested in really a lot of the issues I'm still interested in now, which is how to craft programs and policies that are responsive to the needs of children and youth.
Ever since I was a little girl, I was interested in kids, and I wanted to kind of look at what are the ways in which we can improve the way they turn out. Being the most vulnerable population, members of a population, it's easy to see how they can not end up in a good place. So I've been always interested in figuring out how do people, you know, how do parents help them, how do teachers help them, how do they turn out the way they do, and what can I do, what's my role in that process, can I help? So I think that led me to developmental science, which really is the purpose, or the goal of it is just to come up with research that helps to promote the development of children. So I was hooked.